Yeah, good afternoon, guys. This is Victor Vincent. So today I'm going to be talking about a word that is commonly used. It's called disgust, okay? And I'm going to be using three people to give example on this word. So first, I'm going to be using Mrs. Okpaika. Second, I will be using John Osaigie. And thirdly, I will be using myself, Victor Vince. So let's start. So, Mrs. Okpaika, she's a married woman, okay? She's a full-time housewife. And the husband is responsible for everything because she was not working. Like, it's very common for, like, we that come from Africa, for the husband to be a breadwinner. So, Mrs. Okpaika wanted to buy bra and pint. So she went to the husband and asked the husband if the husband can give her some money just to buy bra pint. But the husband screamed at her and shouted at her, and she felt disgust, okay? Disgust is basically the feelings that arose when something unpleasant, you know, something not really nice happened to you. So she was disgusted because of his husband's behavior. So she went to her room and started crying. And from that day, she vowed that she will never go to her husband and ask for money. So what did she do? She started watching YouTube channel, going to professional courses. And today, Mr. Okpaika is the CEO of one of the microfinance bank in Nigeria. Very successful, just for making that decision. You know, then the second person I'm talking about is John Osaigie. You know, I used to follow John Osaigie, and I watched one of his video. You guys have followed John Osaigie, you know he has a taxi license. So there's this story he tells. I think he said it was one of his experiences in America, that one of the passengers in the car spit in his face. You know, that thing stick with him. You know, most of you know John Osaigie. I don't know if he's bragging, but according to him, he have up to about 50 employees working for him in Edo State. The point I try to make here is that John Osaigie, okay, he was disgusted because a passenger in his taxi actually spit in his face. So that make him to make change. The last one I'm going to be talking about is myself. Okay, when I was growing up, I used to have this family member that used to come from abroad. So once she come to visit, she asked us to go to Ogwalego Rice to go and buy some rice for her and her friends. So what usually happens, we go to Ogwalego, we buy this rice, I bring the rice to them. So she don't give us money to buy our own rice for ourselves. So what usually happens that once they all finish eating, after they have eaten, they have bash, then she will leave the remaining rice and use her teeth to cut the meat and put it in the rice. So that's what she usually gave to us, and that's what we have to eat. Okay? That's the same thing you give to a dog, you know? So the point I'm trying to make here is that I was not happy with the situation. It was unpleasant. So that made me to make a decision that, look, I have to be okay. Okay, so today I can happily tell you that I'm able to eat Ogwalego rice. Not only I'm able to eat Ogwalego rice, I can take my friends there and buy them Ogwalego rice. The point here is, what are you going through? What are you going through in your marriage? What are you going through where you are working? Are you unsatisfied? You know, are you disgusted about the situation? Do you want to change it? Okay? Let me quickly give you a quote. This quote is from Jim Rohn. Jim Rohn once says that, he said, emotion, okay? Emotion is the beginning of civilization, okay? Emotion is attached to disgust. The disgust is a feeling, okay? You understand me? Disgust is a feeling. So according to Jim Rohn, emotion is the beginning of civilization. What is Jim Rohn trying to tell us? Jerome is trying to tell us that once you get angry, okay, and decided to use that passion, that angry, that emotion positively, it's going to change your life. Just for example, the human existence. I guess this is what happened when the human was, before they discover share, you know, before they discover share that they can sit on a share. I think most of the guys get fed up, you know, just standing. And one day they decide, look, we need to be able to sit down. So that is where the idea comes from, creating a share. That's why human today can sit in a share. So ideas usually comes from when you are disgusted because you start thinking of how to get yourself out of that particular situation. And I was watching a video recently that was sent to me on WhatsApp, you know. There's this African woman. I think she was from Nigeria because everything she was saying was related to Nigeria. And she talked about the job she is doing, that she, as a nurse, she has to clean the house of all these old people in the hospital, and she's not happy about it. And the parents is in Nigeria. I think he said the father is 89. The father is about to die now, and she don't have the opportunity to go and spend time with the father. You know, so she's disgusted with her job, and she is disgusted with her situation. Okay, and there's hope. You know, this is where we come in. Okay, I'm a business coach. Okay, I'm a business coach. I'm a life coach. Okay, two in one. So what I will do is, I can advise you. Okay, because the only situation that can get you out of this life you are living, doesn't matter if you live in America, it doesn't matter if you live in Ireland where I live, it doesn't matter if you live in UK, it doesn't matter where you live. The only thing that will get you out of this mess or this disgusting situation you are living in, okay, is business. It's becoming an entrepreneur. Okay, that's where we come in. Okay, I have lots of ideas. I've read a lot of books on entrepreneurship, on businesses. My degree is in business accounting. So I'm the right person to advise you on what to do to get out of your situation if you are disgusted. If you are happy with your 9-to-5 job, you don't have to do anything. But if you know you are feeling bad about your situation at this moment and you want change, then you got to hook us up, you know? You know? So guys, that's a wrap. And do have a productive day. If you are watching this from YouTube, please subscribe to my channel, and there are more wonderful videos coming your way. Okay, thanks for listening. Bye.